my name is Mark Trefferman. I'm a product manager in IDT's RF business. Today I'd like to introduce the F2910 RF switch. The F2910 single pole, single throw switch is the newest addition to our growing RF switch portfolio. The device has an operating frequency range of 30 to 8,000 megahertz and has excellent RF performance. This device incorporates our new constant impedance feature, which I'll talk about later. Now let's take a closer look at some of the key performance attributes at 4 GHz. An insertion loss of 0.67 dB, isolation 41 dB, return loss 20 dB, an IP3 of 65 dB, and an IP2 of 118 dB, P1 dB of 35 dB. The device supports a wide supply voltage range of 2.7 to 5.5 volts and either 1.8 or 3.3 volt control logic. It has an operating temperature range of minus 55 to 105 C and is in a small 2x2mm DFN package. Some of the applications supported are 4G and LTE advanced base stations, distributed antenna systems or DAS, as well as other communication equipment, as well as test and measurement. Now I'd like to talk about constant impedance technology, or KZ for short. KZ controls the impedance during the RF switching process. The upper left drawing shows a simplified Bach diagram consisting of a driver amplifier connected to the switch input and an amplifier and antenna connected to each of the switch output paths. You can see the switch has the RF input connected to the lower RF output path. Now let's take a look at the drawing on the lower right, which shows the RF paths of switch. The RF input is now connected to the upper RF output path. A standard or non-KZ switch does not control the impedance when switching RF ports. This can result in a large voltage wave standing ratio, or VSWR transient, shown in red. This could stress both the upstream and downstream components connected to the switch. In addition, the VSWR transient stressing other components, it will also create a voltage stress on the switch itself, possibly damaging it or reducing its reliability. A KZ switch, highlighted in blue, maintains near constant impedance when switching between RF ports, minimizing the VSWR transient or stress on the switch itself. To show how KZ works, I'll use an example of a single pole, single throw absorptive switch with and without KZ switching the RF common path to each of the RF output ports, RF 1 and 2. For simplicity, I've shown a single stack switch FET in a series shunt configuration. Let's look at the top left drawing, the non-KZ or standard switch. The switch shows the RF signal path between RF common and RF 1 with the unused RF 2 path terminated to ground. Now let's switch the RF path connecting RF common to RF 2. The standard switches do not control the timing very well at individual gate control signals when switching RF ports. The top center drawing shows it's possible for both RF 1 and RF 2 series FETs and the shunt FETs to all be off at the same time, resulting in a large impedance change. With all the FETs off, RF common goes from saying 50 ohms to high impedance, creating a large VSWR transient on RF common, reflecting the signal back to the source. This transient would create a high voltage stress on the switch itself, as well as any components connected to RF common. Now let's look at the KZ switch example on the bottom. KZ controls the sequencing of the individual gate control signals when switching RF ports, such that the FETs are neither on or off all at the same time. This results in maintaining a near constant impedance during the switching event. Because the impedance is controlled, there's no VSWR transient or stress on the switch itself. IDT offers a simple-to-use evaluation board to help our customers perform lab measurements. The board consists of a pin header across the top with power, ground, and logic control. There's an RF through calibration port to make it easy to de-embed the trace loss. And finally, there is an RF connectors on each of the RF ports to measure the device's performance.